to Nordic. Over to Bellows. Bellows in the prop. Backhand shot save. Rebound score by Tenorti.
Well, the North Stars got one thing they want, a first goal. You know how many times we've said that in all three series, their play with the lead is far superior than it is when they're tied or behind. They shot it out himself or got it to a teammate who shot it out. Four times already he's done that in this game.
Anderson cutting for the net. It's deflected behind the goal.
Now there's what I'm talking about. When Anderson, who went to the net, decided to continue on into Casey. Now it's pretty tough to call a penalty on that, because Anderson, as we all know, cuts in off the wing as well as any player in this game, in this age or any other age. And after he made the play to try and beat the goalie, he just continued right on into Casey. And you're going to see this happen.
He gives it to Bellows. Gagne's going for the net. Bellows across ice to Broughton. Great save by Fuhr. Again, to Messier. Messier in front, the shot and the save by Casey as Huddy came sneaking in from the point. He tries to dump it in. Semenov picks it up. Backhand shot saved by Casey, and he grabs the rebound.
Well, the Oilers still having an awfully time with their shoot-ins. One of the reasons
is going for the net. It's dropped off to Gagne. His shot saved. Rebound. All around that Edmonton net. Propp was taking a swipe. Bureau picks it up. Three of them start away. Duchesne for Bureau. Bureau shot scores!
A lousy line change gave the 3-on-2 rush, and that's what makes Muckler so mad. Anderson was very late coming off the bench, and it would have been a 3-on-3 had he been out early enough, and then you wouldn't have seen a problem.
Marty fakes it, gives it to Propp. Back to Tenorti, long shot. Fuhr had few problems with it, but managed to hang on with Gagne right in front of him. Thrown by Bellows. Ahead to Gagne. Bellows going for the net. There's the shot, and Bellows was driving for the goal as Fuhr made the save. And that's something, Harry, that Minnesota's done very well in this series. They keep driving to that net many times with a defenseman going after them. Penalty coming up, and then McTavish is decked behind the play by Cherla, and Kevin Lowe charges into him.
Van Helleman saw Brown trip or almost trip Casey, so he's getting a penalty. I think he heard McTavish get hit, and I'm quite sure charging. You can see Kevin Collins giving the signal to Andy, who said, "I didn't see it, I heard it," and they both get penalties. In that end of the ring.
Murphy across to McIver. Big save by Casey, who came out to the top of the circle to challenge. Nobody there from the point. Craig Muni, a backhand shot, clubbed and held by Casey. 11:42 is the time left in the second. It's still 2-0 Minnesota. Nordy's pass intercepted. Here's a breakaway for Tikkanen. Far corner. Dahlquist shot is blocked. Here's a breakaway for Jelena. Saved by Casey. Prop in front. Gagne's shot blocked. Loose puck. Medano can't get it past. Medano has it again. Throws it back to the point. Lynn winds up. Fuhr with another stick. And he pounces on the rebound.
Oh, there's going to be a penalty in front of the net here, I'm afraid.
After it goes Semenov. Picked up in the corner by Murphy. And Tenorti is knocked down, and there's going to be a penalty here to Semenov.
Well, he got the stick right in Tenorti's face as Tenorti tried to take him out along the boards. Van Helleman called it, and this could be a 5-minute job, although I'm fairly certain that Semenov didn't come up too high with the stick. It was just chest high, but it was right in Mark Tenorti's face. And if, in the opinion of referee Van Helleman, it was one that cut Tenorti, and it wasn't just a kid's 2 minutes. Yep, the Oilers get a break there.
Tavish will get it up. Tikkanen races after it against Broughton. Tiikkanen trying to move in front, and he couldn't take the puck with him. He runs into goaltender Casey, and the two of them go down. Smith comes in to help out. Smith throws it in front. Pure makes the first save and then covers up with Stewart, Gavin, and Dolan both searching for the loose puck. McIver skates it out ahead to Simpson to Anderson. He couldn't get a shot away. Throws it in front. Yes, he scores! He was knocked off the puck by Dahlquist. Gavin into the zone, sliding it in front for Bobby Smith. He scores! McIver picks it up. He loses it. Here's Gagne coming in. Gagne getting set. Flips the shot and Pure pounces on the rebound with Brian Propp driving for the net. And now Propp and McIver have an exchange of words. Nothing serious will develop. Has to check. Throws the puck away and Shane has it going in alone. Hit the post. That made on Klima. Throws it in front. Tiikkanen with a shot. Saved by Casey. Back at the line. Charlie Huddy, a long shot. Blocked in front of the net by Dahlquist. Klima. Lead pass for Semenov. Semenov is hooked. Gets the backhand shot away.
10 seconds to go. They lost 2 seconds after the whistle on the clock. There's a penalty being called as they hook Semenov, but because the timer couldn't hear the whistle because of the noise in this rink, Andy Van Helleman had his hand up with 12 seconds to go and blew the whistle. But the timers could not hear the whistle, and the Oilers lost 2 seconds.
They get tied up. It's played to the line. Tiikkanen over to Klima. He one-times it. Casey makes the save. That puck deflected with 3 seconds remaining, and Casey made the save. And now pushing and shoving.
Well, the Oilers tried to bang the puck out of Casey's pads.
He must get that puck back to him, and Tiikkanen will have to one-time it. In front of the net, backhand shot by Murphy, it's blocked, and that's the hockey game. The Minnesota North Stars have upset the defending Stanley Cup champion Edmonton Oilers, and the North Stars will move on to the Stanley Cup final against either Pittsburgh or Boston. That magic carpet ride that took them through Chicago, St. Louis, and now Edmonton will file a flight plan for either Pittsburgh or Boston.
The Oilers came up with a very spirited effort, and I know they ran out of time at the end, but really they lost it in the first period with a couple of bad penalties and 2 goals against. But these Minnesota North Stars are on a mission. There's Bobby Clark. He sweated this one out in the press box, and Chico Rest, the goaltender coach. And I think the Oilers, to a man, will admit, Don, that the North Stars were a better team.